Hi and welcome back to Film Pickle. This is Pushkar Rajesh Shirke and today I'm doing a review of a movie that we were really, really excited about, and that is Badlapur. Yes, this movie by Shriram Raghavan has been out in theaters lately. People have given rave reviews of it. Many people are excited about it. Many people are not excited about it. So I went and watched the movie myself since I was so excited to watch it, and my reactions are as follows. First thing, for Shriram Raghavan, this has been a great comeback. Alright, he had entirely lost his credibility after Agent Vinod in the sights of many people who loved his previous movies like Ek Haseena Thi and Johnny Gaddar. Agent Vinod was a major letdown, and this movie sort of reclaims his zone, and it feels like, yes, he finally had the calling shots as a director to make this movie. What works about Badlapur? Alright, it's a great story, it's some phenomenal performances. Maybe the pace is a bit loose, but the story overall interests you a lot, and it has a great song which is very catchy, but that's about it of the entire movie. I don't think it has anything beyond this. And why do I say this? Let me get personal about this. Okay, I personally love the movie. Alright, I love the story. I would give the movie a 9 out of 10, okay, if it did not have a few flaws that I will now tell you about. One, the movie moves at too slow a pace and in a confused way, alright? What Shriram Raghavan had here on hand was the chance to create a movie that could have been one of India's first slow burn classics, alright? When you're talking slow burn, you're talking of movies like Drive, you're talking of movies like Gran Torino, which move at a slow pace, but they keep gripping you throughout till the end when they deliver that one single solo message that knocks you out. Alright, this movie had that at its core. It was exactly it. If I had read the story, that is exactly what it would have been. Had Badlapur been a book, it would have been a slow burn book. But the movie does not deliver on that. Now, I don't know whether it was a call of the producers or it was in some way a fault of the director that this happened, but the movie confuses itself between being a slow burn movie and being an action movie. There are parts where I don't think there is clarity on where this movie is headed. You try to force up the pace, drop the pace, and that does not really work for the movie. And it's especially disappointing when you reach a point where this movie is actually supposed to deliver its knockout punch and it fails. Trust me, the story-wise, the movie is perfect. It had perfect sense, but that does not come across when you watch the movie. The end finale blow that is supposed to hit you like a hammer in the face, like Varun Dhawan hits the people in the face in the movie, does not really happen, and that sort of really disappointed me. Not that I still wouldn't ask you to go watch this movie. I would say absolutely go watch this movie. It's a great movie. Download it, watch it in theaters. It'll still be worth your while. It's a great movie to watch. Alright? But the only regret I have about this movie is that we just wasted a chance to make a good movie, like a great movie, out of a movie that now turns out just a good movie to watch, right? I would honestly rate this movie a 7 out of 10, okay? But considering it's from Bollywood, I'm tempted to rate it an 8 out of 10 because this still is a great move for Bollywood. Bollywood is finally moving towards something more grittier, more real, a little more slow burn, which has never been Bollywood style, right? Bollywood has always been about ding dong, disco dance and hangama and all that shit. And for a change, it's good to see a movie that allows some emotions to soak in. But again, this movie did not go the entire slow burn way. Most of the emotions are not entirely soaked in. I know the story wants to convey it, okay? But in the way it's shown, maybe at the call of the director or at the call of the DOP or the way it's all strung together, those emotions never really soak into you. You actually don't feel the emotion that he wants to convey. Yes, you understand that on the outset he's frustrated, but the depth of it does not sink in. The depth that this story had does not sink in via the movie. Alright? People who are afraid of spoilers, tune out right now because I'm about to give one. Okay? This is a spoiler. Spoiler alert, everybody tuned out? Okay, let's go to the spoiler. In the end, okay, Nawazuddin Siddiqui, who was the villain all along the movie, does something that is heroic, transforming him into the hero of the movie, and Varun Dhawan, who was the hero of this movie all along, into someone who's less of a bright character and more of a dark, undertony villain's character. Okay? this is the point where he had the chance to turn it on its head and deliver what actually makes that difference, to get in the emotion of the story, where out of forgiveness, out of an understanding, Nawazuddin has evolved from being the guy who was a villain all along to being someone who's even above the hero. And the hero realizing the futility of revenge. Alright? The futility of revenge kind of stories are some of my favorite stories in life. Alright? I love revenge as a concept, and I love even more when you concentrate on futility of revenge as a concept piece of your film, which turns out as a revenge film. Right? There are loads of classics I love on these lines. And this movie just lost it there, because that moment just does not sink in. That moment where you realize that Nawazuddin has gone beyond this guy and become the bigger person, it does not sink in. That confrontation does not grab you. That confrontation does not grip you. That confrontation does not leave scope for any kind of emotional understanding on the viewer's end for it to be soaked in. It gets rushed off. I think just the last 15 minutes of the movie, if they were done with a little more finesse and a little more depth in terms of the emotion it's trying to convey, it would have done a lot better. So here we have a movie that is a great movie, a good movie, but really, really, really could have been a classic for Bollywood. So that's my only regret about this movie. But do go watch Badlapur. I will still give it an 8 out of 10 for being a Bollywood movie this awesome. This is Film Pickle and Pushkar Shirke signing off.